Yo guys, we got the coin mats here on the store, couchcollectibles.com. First 25 to order is going to get a free Couch Collectibles sticker. So make sure you guys get your orders in. We only have like 47, 48 of these a piece. Yeah, get your guys' orders in. Couchcollectibles.com, I'll leave a link down in the description and in the comments below. Also, if you comment within the first hour of this video being uploaded, you're gonna be entered for a 40% silver half dollar. So let's just hop right into it. All right, so in 1976, we're gonna look at the Eisenhower dollar coin prices, what these coins have sold for, different types of errors on these coins, and so much more. I've actually done a video on this, but I wanted to compile everything about the 1976 in this video. So let's start off first with a couple error coins. Now, this is a 1976 S mint mark that has been struck through tape. So when the coin was being produced, some kind of tape got in the way when the coin was struck. So we see that there here on the right side of the reverse of the coin. Now this coin here sold for over $1,500 as a result of that. Now here's a 1976 proof Eisenhower dollar. Did I say Kennedy half dollar? I don't know. It's Eisenhower dollars is what we're looking at. This is a reverse lamination mint error. So we can see that it's a very obvious type of error. You won't need a coin microscope to look for that. And this coin sold for nearly $500. Here's another 1976. Now this one's really cool. It's been double struck with the second strike being off center, 80% off center to be exact. And we see that there at the bottom of the coin. You see the top design of the coin at the bottom of the coin going through the date. And this coin sold for over $700. Not bad for a dollar coin. Turn it in $700. Now this coin here has been struck through some reading, and we see that here on the reverse of the coin going through the lettering $1. So very obvious type of error there. This coin sold for over $800. Now, just a couple things real quick. This is a 1976 that is copper nickel. So this does not have any silver. Those weigh 22.68 grams. Now, if you want to look for the silver ones from 1976, those are going to weigh 24.59 grams. And we also have different types. So here is a 1976 D type 1. Now, the biggest way to tell the difference is the lettering on the reverse of the coin. So look at that lettering there. It's really bold and thick. Here's actually an example of type 1 versus type 2. You see on the left, type 1. Very thick lettering here on the right. A lot thinner lettering here on the right for type 2. Now here's actually how many they made in 1976. So if you want to pause the screen and see which they made the most or the least of, you can do that. So you see that some of them are common, some of them are less common. So here's another strike through taking place on a 1976. And this coin sold for over $900, nearly a $1,000 Eisenhower dollar coin. So that's really cool. All right, so for the type 2. Now this is interesting here because this is a 1976 D mint mark that was struck on a 40% silver planchet. So I told you how they made silver ones and non-silver ones and the different weights to look for. This was not supposed to be silver. It is the D mint mark. They were not supposed to be silver. This coin sold for over $8,000 because it was struck on a silver planchet. So this one is actually silver. So all you have to do is weigh them to find out if it is silver or not. So keep that in mind. Now here's a 1976 D. This is the type 1. The only reason that this is valuable is because it's got the high grade of a mint state 67. So if you got these coins, they're not in the best condition. They're not really gonna be worth anything, especially the clad ones here. This one is not silver. And this coin did sell for over $11,000, again, because of the high grade, because of the condition. Here is a defective clad layer here on the front of the Eisenhower dollar. Man, that looks awesome, doesn't it? That is a really awesome error. This coin sold for over $490, nearly a $500 coin. Here's another error coin. Now this is the 1976 that has been struck through an unknown object. So something got in the way again when producing this coin, and apparently they have no idea what that object was when grading this coin. So this coin did sell for over $640. Really cool type of error there. Now for the 1976 S mint mark, we also have the proof. And this is the clad. So we have a clad, so non-silver, it's not silver. It is the type one. It's got a absolutely perfect grade on it. So that means that, you know, cannot get in any better condition that it's in. And this coin sold for over $25,000 as a result of that. So perfect grade, that's like hitting a lottery to get a perfect grade. Now here is a 1976 S Mint Mark that is the type one. And this coin sold for over $1,700 as a result of that high grade, the Mint State 68 grade. Now here is the other version of the proof coin. This is still a perfect grade as well. However, this is a silver one. So the other one we looked at was non-silver. This is the silver version. And we got the S Mint Mark. The Mint Mark's gonna be right there above the date below Eisenhower. So, and this coin sold for nearly $7,000, over a $6,900 coin. Now here is a 1976 Type 1 that just has the high grade, and it is the No Mint Mark. And this coin's got some really awesome toning to it as well. And because of the high grade, this coin sold for over $7,000 as well. Now here is a type two. Now this is the No Mint Mark. Looks pretty normal, typically, you know, what you might see in your coin collection. However, it does have a high grade of a Mint State 67. So that's what's gonna give it all of its value. This coin sold for over $6,000. $6,000. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you all in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.